Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. I've got freshest PSVR news in the village just for you, so let's start right now. And today I've done compilation of the upcoming physical releases, because I know how much some of you gets fucked off when you buy a game and then you find out that it's actually getting physical release. So to keep you informed, I've done compilation of the upcoming 17 games which you're gonna be able to buy on disc. We're gonna start from games from Perb Games, which is the company which got like the biggest catalog of VR games. They basically just doing physical releases for VR games. This is the bunch of people who's been working for bigger companies, and they was like, fuck that shit, fuck them. We're gonna open our own company when we don't have to suck life out of the developers. We actually gonna help them to publish their games, and that's what they're doing. And they've got 6 games to be released on the discs, you know, for you to have and hold, do photos of your collection to show people. It's just nicer to have a game in the box in it. You can just pick up the box and look at it and say, yes, that's mine. So let's have a look at their games. The Walker is an action adventure fantasy game. You basically be fighting off hordes and hordes of the demonic enemies who are there to kill you, because they are dickheads. So in this game you'll be using spells and weapons to defend yourself. You're gonna have some magic powers, but as well, you know, good old fashioned weapons, because magic is just not enough those days. So this game caught people attention because it's got some beautiful looking graphics, and you can see it on screen, they are very, very beautiful. Very good looking game with some good action in it. No release date for this one yet. I think it's this year, but I don't know when. Once I know more, of course I let you know, of course I will. Right, okay, another game is Blind. And in this game, which is like a narrative driven adventure, which is very nice because I like to be part of the story. And actually wait, in VR I am inside that story. I'm not the part of the story. I am the story. I am the master of the story, which I am inside. I'm penetrating the story. So the Blind will use the echolocation. So think about it like Stifled. You'll be like a bat, but you'll be human who just uses echolocation. It works great in VR. I love Stifled, so I assume Blind will be a great game as well. But this game, Reborn, Samurai Awoken, this is the one I'm really, really looking forward to, and I'm definitely buying that 100%. I can't wait till it's release, because the gameplay in this game looks amazing. You're playing as a famous samurai warrior of feudal Japan called Yukumira Sanada. You'll be welding dual laser katanas, and just for this simple fact, this game is worth buying. Laser katanas, it's like having an orgasm twice. So, apart from those katanas, you'll be able to hold pistols as well, and you'll be having some psychic powers. But you don't, you know, you can choose which weapon you're holding in your hand. So you can have katana, laser katana, let me say. Amazing. In one hand and pistol in other, of course your psychic powers as well, and you'll be fighting hordes of enemies attacking you, but this game will concentrate a lot on the boss fights, which supposed to be crazy, mad, full of action, amazing boss fights. So I'm really looking forward to Reborn Samurai Awoken. This is the game I'm really can't wait for. It's meant to release last year, and I've been very excited waiting for it, but it's obviously got delayed. It's not release date for it yet, but I hope it's gonna be very soon, and I'm definitely buying this on disc. This is gonna be one which I'm not gonna download, even, you know, even if I want day one review, I just pass it, because I want this in my collection of games. I want to have it on the shelf. Next game they releasing, this one got actually release date and the price, and I spoke about it yesterday and a lot of multiple times in past as well. Time Carnage will release on March 16th, you can pre-order it for £19.99 quid now, and in this game you like traveling through different worlds, you like traveling through time, but not to just look around, you traveling through time just to kill shit, because you are a person who likes to use their weapons, and there is 25 weapons, different weapons, there is even a flamethrower, how nice is that. So this will be out next month, very nice. If you want it on disc, remember, don't get it from the store, go to shop or pre-order it from Game in UK. Another game they gonna release is Affected the Manor, so this is out on Rift, I think. It's a part of Trilogy, I think will they release it all at once, I don't know. There is no gameplay in it, but apparently it's very scary, gonna get scared and fart, or shart. Or just shit yourself, depends how scared you get in. And it is like a walking simulator, think like Hit Daylight, that's a bit a walking simulator, but very, very scary one. And the last game from Perb Games collection of games, which they gonna give us on disc, because that's how nice they are, is the American Dream. And in this game, You basically using guns to solve everyday problems. It's meant to take piece of the gun culture those days, because you know that's what they think what's happening. And that's what you're gonna do. You'll be flipping the burgers, picking up the donuts with your gun. Whatever you want to do with your gun, you'll be able to do it in this game. Right, so that's the 6 games from Perp Games, and I cannot wait for Reborn Samurai Awoken. Right, but we've got some more games coming, and of course Blood and Truth. You can actually pre-order this now and guess the price. It's £59.99. How expensive, how that's gonna cost in America? Will it be like $70 or something? I'm assuming the game which is in UK, they're just ripping people off as always because they are dicks. I mean, come on, they sold my missus Move controllers, 2 Move controllers, not even packaged in a box for £120. When I found this out, I've been like, cancel. There was like dicks about it and all, but anyway. So, Blood and Truth, it was announced not long ago. It's like an action game from the studio which brought us, obviously, VR Worlds and the beautiful London Haste. And they're saying it's gonna be like an action movie and there will be plenty of elements in an action movie. Pretty much anything what's happened in action movie, it will be in this game. It looks great, it's gonna use like an on-rail system, but the one you can kind of control. And London Studios can pull out great games, so Blood and Truth, it's coming, no release date yet, but apparently it's £60, which I believe it's gonna be cheaper and it's just GameShop being retarded again. Right, another game which get physical release, but actually it's gonna get limited support after the release, is Dreams. So in this game you'll be able to like do basically whatever you want and build your own games and shit like that, but I said it in past, it's not gonna have PSVR support from the start, and after the release they probably gonna add it, but it will be only limited, and you can pre-order this as well for £44.99. Right, next game is Transference, and this you can pre-order as well from Game, which selling it for like £50, but if you go to Argos in UK you can pre-order it for a more decent price of £36.99. So in this game you will come face to face with a fractured family as you freely explore their minds. You'll be walking around dreamlike home filled with all sorts of crazy shit to discover, and you'll be collecting the evidence of family history so you can choose how to repair their lives. So it sounds like you'll be taking part of daily living on some kind of very fucked up family. So this is done by collaboration between the Elijah Wood Company and the Ubisoft. It's supposed to come out in Q2, so you know, this spring, so shouldn't be that long. Another physical release, you probably all know about it, Bravo Team, coming out on March 7th. And it's very big difference in price in UK and US. I don't know why in UK this game costs £25 and in US it's $40. What's going on? But anyway, it will support aim controller. You can get it actually with aim bundle for £54, so it's very cheap for aim. And this is coming from Supermassive Game. They lately released Impatient, which a lot of people was disappointed with. I didn't even finish it because it's bored me to death, this game. But should we worry about this game? Because so far we've seen like gameplay from same area. They said you'll be through the game, you're gonna go through the entire city, but how big is this city? I mean, if this game gonna last like hour and a half, it's gonna be a bit shitty, will it? But at least it's got aim support. And it's coming out next month on March 7th. Another game, Quar Infernal Machines. So this is a turn-based strategy. It will have move support. They're promising you 6 hours of gameplay. And they're saying there will be more than 12 levels. What's that mean? Is it 13, 15? Just give me the number. More than 12. How random. And this will come out on 30th of March. For £19.99, you can pre-order it from football media website in UK. I don't think this will get global release for physical. I'm not sure. I know it will in Europe anyway. Right, another game, Ace Combat 7. You obviously know about it. Coming out in 2018, priced as £54.99. And it's gonna have separate VR mode, but it's still gonna have around 12 hours of gameplay. So I assume it's gonna be like missions without any cinematic events. I'm not sure, they're not exactly specified VR support. But it's gonna be a big part of the game, and of course Ace Combat, you know, flying planes in VR. For some reason we only got Ultra Wings, and then I don't know why no more, like cockpit games. You know, we've got some space shooters, but like honestly, there's so many, like, I don't know, so much potential in our flying games. I don't know why we don't have many of them. But anyway, Ace Combat 7, it's gonna be out this year, no release date yet. Next game, Mind Taker. This is yet another horror game when you walk in an exploring sheet. So, regarding the physical release, you can actually pre-order it now, but hold your horses, because it will cost you a lot of money, because you need to put a pledge of fucking 100 euro on PlayStarter, which is like Spanish Kickstarter, and then you're gonna get physical copy of the game for 100 euro. But if you want to support the game, then feel free to do that. I'm not sure if it's gonna be just limited to that, or if it will get proper release in the, you know, various locations and various shops. Another game what you can support on PlayStarter and get the physical copy is Intruders Hide and Seek. So for physical copy of this, you have to pledge 60 euro, and just like with Mind Taker, I don't know if you'll be able to pick it up in other shops, or is it just like a limited edition to reward people who help them out, you know, the most. And Intruders Hide and Seek looks interesting, because you're actually playing like a little child who can't defend themselves from people who broke into their house and like basically assaulted all the family. So, you know, very, very interesting. Next game, Cyber Dimension Neptunia 7R releases on April 24th. You can pre-order it for $59.99, but the VR mode for it is only limited to like a VR dimension when you can interact with the various girls of the game, you know, because Japanese, they like that shit. That's why they're releasing Summer Lesson 3-in-1 bundle, not in Europe, not in US, just in Asia, I think. Not gonna talk much about it, because every time I try to show gameplay, fucking Bandai demonetizing my videos and claiming shit of it. So anyway, I don't know, never been interested in Summer Lesson. But that's all of your physical releases, a lot of games. So if you like to collect the games and somehow you bought few games digitally, now you know. Now you know that those games will be on disc for you to add to your collections. So right, that's it from me for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, hit like and subscribe, and I'll be back.